virtual table is good. Dynamically produces a result set using a named query or select statement. So it will dynamically produce those things and acts as a filter for data retrieved from underlying tables. It's a very important point. And that's what I said to you, that I'll just take you over there in my different slide that I've created for you as well. So dynamically produces a result set using a named query or select statement. So it basically does what? It will produce dynamically a result, and that result will be shown. So it can be result by using a named query. We'll see that we can create query views in SQL Management Studio as well, or maybe in Workbench as well. And then we can use that as a filter. So it's a simple example here, create view. We are creating view, its name is phone list, as select company name, contact name, phone from customers. So we can create a view over here. That view would be providing us the information from that. So let's first move to this slide, and then I will give you an example in this Management Studio. We'll try to create views, and we'll see that what are those views doing for us. Now, views are not that completely discussed over here, and there are different slides for that, but I've just tried to gather few important things about views. So views used to focus, simplify, and customize the perception each user has of database. So again, it is giving us the focused, simplified, and customized perception of each user. So as I told you in the beginning, that views will be important for showing what you need, for showing what you are meant to be shown, what you are required to be shown. So it's used to focus, simplify, and customize. That point is saying them that every user has a view of database. The data entry operator has a different view. The admin of database is a different view. The CEO of the company's manager and people those who want to see the results, they have the different views. So views will provide them, like everyone, the conceptually an area which will be only important for them. Okay, it can be used as security mechanism. This is important point which is there, but again, it's not explicitly mentioned. Can be used as a security mechanism. Why it's a security mechanism? By allowing users to access data through the view without granting the users permissions to directly access the underlying base tables of issue. So again, you always want to secure. So security is another problem, or security is another concern that we basically keep in mind while we are designing the views, while we are developing the views. We'll keep that security also in mind. Why? We are not providing users to go deeper into our tables, and we are not granting them access to the table. Rather, we are creating the virtual tables out of it. Rather, we are creating those virtual tables and trying to show those virtual tables to people. And the user only seeing what has been shown to them. And the user gets the feeling that whatever I'm seeing is the right thing, or is that the table. So, but again, we know that we have not taken them. As I told you, and as we have discussed before, the injection like and those attacks that people like to do and people would like to do on your databases. So view will be providing one of the view, and people will be looking at that and might be thinking that this is the table, but that won't be a table. That would be maybe a virtual table taken from. So displays one or more database records on the same page. So it will display one or more database records, and those records have been taken maybe from one table or maybe from multiple tables. So it can come from the multiple tables as well. So displays one or more database records on the same page. It can display one or more database. A key of creating useful database is a well-chosen set of views. So it's another very important consideration that if you are creating a useful database, it has to have a good set of views, well-chosen set of views, so that every user. So now all aspects of view can be customized. The customers' views can be customized. Name of the view, fields that appear in the view, the column title for each field, as you know, use this as or without as also, it can change the order of the fields in the view, the width of columns in the view, as well as overall width of the view, set of records that appear in the view, filtering, which is again the what set of records that you want to display, the order in which records are displayed in the view, sorting and grouping, and column totals for numeric and currency fields, totaling and subtotaling. And again, as we have discussed, we have just basically tried to implement all those things one way or other in this our solution. If you see, we have not created a view by itself, but we have used select statements. So whatever comes through select statement is also a sort of a virtual table. So we have done a lots of things where sometimes we are doing, the calculations over here. and then just putting them in the column name or something. So anyhow, so we can change all those things by of views, and we can create new views. Ways to create new view in database. So how can we create a new view from scratch? Number one, or we can make a copy of an existing view and then modify it. So again, it's not a big deal. But yes, here comes something interesting. Characteristics slash types of views. So what are the characteristics or types of views? So materialized view, there is something called a materialized view. We'll see a materialized view and we'll see a few examples of all of them. Then we have simple views, and then we have complex views, and then we have dynamic views. So these are the four generally defined characteristics of views that we have: materialized, we have simple views, complex views, and dynamic views that we can use. So a quick definition, a quick one-liner, two-liners for everyone. Materialized view is a replica of a target master from a single point in time. So materialized view is basically, it is mentioned as a target master, as we are saying. So we basically just try to create something as a master view or a master, master set of fields that we want to show to the user. We keep them at a site, and then we make a replica for that, and that is called a materialized view. So you can call it a master or a single point in time picture, or what you call it, you call it a snapshot, something, a snapshot of view has been saved. And then by taking a replica of it, we create materialized view. Then simple views are created from tables and are used for creating secure manipulation over the tables or structure of the database. They are called simple views. And complex views of type, which may comprise of many elements such as tables, views, sequences, and other similar objects of databases. So again, a complex view can have multiple things inside it. Dynamic views, virtual tables, the views of which data is not stored, and expressions used to build view are used to collect the data dynamically. So, dynamic views are typically called as virtual tables, or maybe, generally we call them virtual tables to all the views, but the dynamic views are virtual tables. And why they are virtual tables? Because views of which data is not stored and expressions used to build the view are used to collect the data dynamically. So again, we are just dynamically just collect data, or we are dynamically just see data, and then we just leave that out. So create view, STView1. So we have just create, this is an example, creating a view. If you want to create a view, STView1 as select S name, F name, PR name from the student or whatever. And we can have our own example. I've just included that example, but we can create views in that. So if you can all open that up, like our environment, and I'm expecting you, all of you, to have Northwind database working for you. So I am expecting every one of you to be on this, so that we just practice that out, and then we'll move forward. So I will need a yes if everyone is ready with their SMS, right? So that's why I placed the dash line. If you can just quickly give a response that yes, you have done something. Okay, Alex, thank you. Alex is okay. Duncan, yes, Sasha, thank you very much. All right. So yes. So graphically, how can we create views? You see that we have something called a views table over here, and we have different views being all like you would have few views already being created over here. Now, what we can do is we can just right click on it, and if we can create a new view. So it's generally recommended that rather than tables, if you have previously being made some views, you can use those views for creating the new views. It's generally recommended, but again, you can use the tables as well, and you can create the tables and by using those tables as well to create the views. All right, so we have already there are certain views. How many views do you see in your views form? Dan or Marisa, anyone? How many views do you see over here? All the same ones as you. Are you sure, Mohammed? Because I have certain STV view one I have just already created. So again, yes. So there will be certain views that you have. So again, what you can do is you can select, for example, you can select some of the, for example, current product list, and by pressing Control, you can select maybe orders quantity, anything that you want. And I've selected three of them, and I've selected three views out of them, and I want to add them. So just by pressing Control, right, as you know, that we can use. You can just close that one up after putting that. So these are the three views. So combining them, I'm just trying to create a new view. That will, so if you see at the bottom, you see that we have seen that it's basically doing or creating something for us. So now I say product ID from this one, for example, and then maybe then order ID from this one, customer ID from this one, and category name and a product name, whatever is your requirement, you can just select them. And after selecting, you can just close it up. And you will be closing, it will of course ask you that, do you want to save this as a view? And you say that, yes, I want to save it. And this is, I will call it my view, 1, 2, 3, whatever you can rename it, and you can save that. So now if you see that these view should appear here, if you refresh your environment, you will see my view 1, 2, 3 that I've created. So if I just double click on it, or maybe if I just select top 100 rows. So depending upon, again, depending upon my view, whatever is that, the things, if you remember, I just selected that product ID, ordered ID, customer ID, category name, and then product name. So it has been basically showing all those to me. And it has selected the top 1,000 rows out of it. So again, this is one view, and then you can just create a view by using that code as well. Select create views and all those things, and we'll discuss all rest of the things as well. So this is one example of this queue of views, and then we'll today in our one of the other example, we might create more views in that typical example. So that was what about views, and I will share that PowerPoint slide as well with you. The views can be used like a normal table for select, for example, select contact name, phone name from the phone list. So it can be, this can be also a virtual table that is coming, and you know, you can add an as or aliasing. So if aliasing will be doing it for you. So as I told you, and we have already discussed, and we'll have those slides, it's useful for simplification of complex query by reducing code. So first of all, simplification of complex queries, so that people only look at what they are looking for, usability of queries, and we are it's quite obvious that we use that reusability of the queries, and then security. So referencing a reduced set of columns, and of course that is one good motivation for that. So common considerations: views cannot be created using order by in the definition. So there are certain common considerations that order by cannot be used to create views, and all other select clauses are usable. So again, order by is the exception out of these, and we can use aggregate functions as well that we are about to discuss, and we'll discuss those aggregate functions. Insert, update, delete statements must reference columns in only one base table. So again, these statements must reference columns in only. So modifying data in view is not common. So again, basically we try to do that, what that we do not, generally we do not do use views to update, like views to modify data. So rather we usually try to just do what from the views that we just try to, you know, more or less like a viewing or displaying something to the user rather than having that. So we basically it's not recommended to use modification or modify few things by using the views. Right, so be careful of table schema changing, it could affect a view. So whenever table schema changes, anyone would like to tell me what is a table schema, a definition for table schema, what is the schema of a table? Anyone from you, Sasha maybe, or whatever, whoever would like to chime in? Schema or table schema? Yes. So then my question is that, if you see, be careful of table schema changing, it could affect a view. So my question is, what is table schema or schema in general? This one. I hope I'm pronouncing it correctly. How you set up the database internally, tables and their columns, etc., foreign keys and whatnot. Okay, anyone else? Muhammad has given a good definition. Schema, set of columns and their data types. Right. Yes, that's one way or other. That's both definitions. Can anyone else give a quicker definition or a different definition of a schema? So how your table is organized, or the structure of the table, or as Dan says, the set of columns and their data types, and as So Mohammed was more talking about the database schema specifically, rather tables and the columns, etc., foreign keys and whatnot. So again, how your views, like how you have set up your database, how your what is the you know, the structural representation of your data, that how it will do that. In SQL Server, you can use schema binding as an option. When creating the view, it prevents the underlying table from being modified. So schema binding will prevent us. So this is one good way of finding out that we don't want to want that view to modify something. So we'll use that schema binding, and we'll see that example also here. Now, drive tables. There is one another concept of drive tables, and it's more like more or less it is covered in the view then and sim like that. So similar to subquery, but it is used in the from clause. So in from clause, we use drive tables usually, also similar to a view, but the query is temporary. So query is temporary for that. And you know that view that we have created right now, it had become permanent. And you know that it has been stored in this our views, and it has certain columns inside it. It has certain things. So it is a permanent sort of thing. But when you talk about when we talk about the drive tables, they are not considered as the permanent one. Rather, they are the temporary objects. Like a view, the drive table must have a name implemented as an alias. So we can have a name of the drive table, and that can be used as implemented as alias. Simple example: select full name from select concat first last name as full name as name table, where full name like A, and you know that then any name starting with A. So now what is being used over here, and you see that we are doing a concatenation from first name and last name, and that concatenate function will do what? It will just take the first name and the last name and concatenate, and it will be named as the full name. So here what we are doing is we are trying to just combine two different columns into one, and then representing that column as a simple name. And so all of that specifically as a name table. So this is second aliasing as a name table, and then where full name like a person. So now what it will do is that it will take out all those name that have full name. The full name which has come out of it will have the starting letter as A, and remainder of it can be anything. So it will just list those down. So this is again temporarily just producing a value, and by using this will be called as a drive table that would be used over here. Now, used to summarize a column of output in some way, we are summarizing a column of output. So again, because there were full name, there were first name, there were second name. So now what we can do is we can summarize them by combining them, and we have just combined them. Often used with group by, use having clause to filter data. So again, we can use this having and all those things to for aggregate. So this is typically for like aggregate functions as well, that aggregate functions are used to summarize the column. So we have already used a lots of aggregate functions. And if you see here, that do you remember that we have used these aggregate functions already? AVG and count, max, min, sum. So again, there are certain other functions being used. So you know that what we'll do by using these aggregate functions, we'll be just trying to, you know, take out the average out of it. If you want to count something, and if you have a, like you, if you